We've got Hart and we've got John Weber tonight. Mask by David Joseph. But before I've introduced our first Valentine, I'm so happy that she's here. Mask by David Joseph. Our first Valentine this evening has won Bistros and Max. She's a recipient of the Julie Wilson Award and the Noel Coward Award. And she's had raves in the New York Times, but she gets my raves because she's got miles and miles and miles of heart. Marissa Mulder.
Hello there, happy Valentine's Day. When Dad and Mother discovered one another, they dreamed of the day when they would love and honor and obey. And during all their modest spooning, they'd blush and speak of honeymooning. And if my memory recalls, they spoke of Niagara Falls. But today, my darling, today, when you meet the one you love, you say, come fly with me. Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic moves, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me. Let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me. Let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You even may hear a gang of angels cheer, 'cause we're together, weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide, absolutely petrified. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so very near. You even may hear a gang of angels cheer, 'cause we're together weather-wise. It's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat those birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly, pack up, let's fly away. It is such a pleasure to be here with you on Valentine's night. I'm so happy KT asked me to be a part of this program. The next song I'm going to sing for you was written by Noel Coward, and it was KT who suggested I sing it. She always has the best ideas for songs. The first time I sang it was at Town Hall, and that was the night that I was surprised by KT and found out that I was the recipient of the Julie Wilson Award. I then went on to sing this in the Noel Coward competition, And I did win, which was a very exciting moment, not to toot my own horn or anything, but it's a song I've come to love so much. And before I was immersed into the cabaret world, I hardly knew Noel Coward. And now I'm just so grateful that I know his music, so much humor, magic, and wit. When it's late and the world is sleeping, our little black cat, no bigger than that, has a date which she's keen on keeping. No use dissuading her, she's serenading her beau in the garden below. She sings, oh, won't you chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, over the garden wall. I'd like to wander for miles and miles, wreathed in smiles, out on the tiles with you. Chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, don't be afraid to fall. Love in the moonlight can be sublime. Now's the time, Charlie, I'm waiting for you if you'll only climb over the garden wall. Every night at about 11, our little cat knows, our little cat goes, quick as light to her private heaven. No use restraining her, she's set on gaining her prize with her amorous cries. Hypnotizing him, chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, over the garden wall. Who gives a damn if the neighbors yell? Let's rebel just for the hell of it. Chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, maybe I'll give my all. Won't you come out and be gay with me? Play with me, stay with me, just try a roll in the hay with me over the garden wall. Chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, over the garden wall. Why not give in to the joys of spring? Have a fling. Why are you lingering? Chase me, Charlie, chase me, Charlie, this is my final call. Pussycat, don't be shy, this is my alibi. Nature intends us to multiply over the garden wall. I just love that song. I've been singing it for so many years now. I'm so glad KT suggested it for me. But again, I'll just say how happy I am to be here. My birthday was not too long ago, so Valentine's Day for me was always a combination of Valentine's and my birthday. And I grew up in snowy Syracuse, New York, and I remember just loving Valentine's Day at school. My mom would help me decorate my very own little Valentine's mailbox with pretty pink paper and lace hearts. And I was so excited to get to school and put it right on my desk to collect all the cards. Whether you're, you know, involved romantically or not, I just think Valentine's Day is such a special day to celebrate all kinds of love. And I hope you're having a beautiful night, and we miss you so much. I just wither and forget all resistance when you and your magic pass by. My heart's in a dither, dear, when you're at a distance. But when you are near, oh my. excites me, that thrills and delights me. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. It isn't your sweet conversation that brings this sensation. Oh no, it's just the nearness of you. One more song for you this evening. Thanks again for watching. Such a pleasure to make music in any way we can during these trying times, and always a pleasure to work with my good friend John Weber on piano. Never doubt you, I can't forget you. I've thought you out, dear. I know your profile and I know the way you kiss. Just the thing I miss on a night like this. If dreams are made of imagination, I'm not afraid of my own creation. With all my heart is here for you to take. Why should I quake? I'm not awake. Isn't it romantic? Music in the night, a dream. The oldest magic word. Isn't it romantic? Merely to be young on such a night as this. Isn't it romantic? Every note that's sung is like a lover's kiss. Sweet symbols in the moonlight. Do you mean that I will fall in love perchance? Isn't it on such a night as this. Isn't it romantic? Every note that's sung is like a lover's kiss. Sweet symbols in the moonlight. Do you mean that thank you, Katie.
And I love your Valentine dress.
And thank I love you. Your Valentine purple.
Happy Valentine's and a belated happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Now, I must tell you that wonderful song by Rodgers and Hart, that wonderful song by Rodgers and Hart has another lyric. There's a film I love called Love Me Tonight with Jeanette MacDonald. And in that film, Maurice Chevalier sings probably one of the most chauvinistic lyrics of all time, but I think Larry Hart must have written this with his tongue planted firmly in his cheek. But I just have to share this with you. From Marie Chevalier. Isn't it romantic? Soon I will have found some girl that I adore. Isn't it romantic? While I sit around, my love can scrub the floor. She kiss me every hour, or she'll get the sack. And when I take a shower, she can scrub my back. Isn't it romantic? On a moonlit night, she'll cook me onion soup. Kiddies are romantic. And if we don't fight, we're soon to have a troop. We'll help the population. It's the duty that we owe to dear old France. Isn't it romance? Isn't it romantic? Isn't it romance? Yes, and now I get to introduce our second Valentine, who's far from chauvinistic because I work with him often. We love each other, and he's a great, one of my favorite singing partners. But I must say, he's also a multi-award winner. But most recently, I'm saying just like a couple of weeks ago, he won the Broadway World Award, which for a show he did called Carried Away that was arranged and conducted by Alex Rybak, who happens to be right here. Hello, Alex. I'm so glad you could be our Valentine tonight. And that show, but he also won a Broadway World Award for a show he did with moi, yes, and John Weber, and directed by the legendary Sandra Lee. It was a Sondheim show. And we got to do it at the Performing Arts Center in New Jersey for PBS. Wouldn't it be wonderful, Jeff, when we're on shows again, on stages? You gotta have hope. Mustn't sit around and mope. Nothing's ever half as bad as appears. Wait till next year and hope. Well, we can hope, Jeff. We can hope. But, you know, until then, we can perform right here at the Mabel Mercer Foundation. I'm so glad you could be the Valentine tonight. Hope, we gotta have hope. Hopefully it's not at next year. It will be in a few months. We'll be on stages again, Rose Hall, Carnegie Hall. Wouldn't that be nice, Jeff? Now Jeff, I'll put this up. It's the most dangerous thing you can do is sing. I'm sorry I sang to you. Now, didn't you work with, no, this is a very special month because Valentine's Day was Donald Smith's favorite holiday. February 3rd, Mabel Mercer was born. Yeah. And Valentine's Day, wasn't Phyllis McGuire born on Valentine's Day? Was she your Valentine? You knew her, didn't you, Jack?
I have two very special Valentine's birthday ladies in my life, and she was one of them.
Oh, please tell us. Tell us more. We love it.
Well, I was a room service waiter at the Regency Hotel in 1985, and Phyllis McGuire was there. She and her sisters were planning their comeback together, and she whisked me away and put me on her household staff on East 77th Street, and there I worked for 2 years, and I left her employ to start my own career, and 2 years after that, she called from Reno and said, "I'm reading your review in Variety. I think you should come open for us." So her birthday is Valentine's Day. It was Valentine's Day, and she will always be one of my special Valentines. So with the miracle of modern cabaret, Alex is gonna help me recreate a McGuire sisters arrangement. This is the first one I ever heard the girls do in their 1985 reunion, and it's built around a Cole Porter song. Did this on Night of 100 Stars. Christine and Dorothy, while I sing Phyllis's part. And Alex and I are in our 38th year of working together. In fact, I was working with Alex back when I was Phyllis McGuire's houseboy, and when she needed a rehearsal pianist, Alex came over and He helped help them work up their number that they did with the Pointer Sisters, which was we'll save for another show. Well, so that song, I Love You, is a Cole Porter song, and it's one of the great things about the American Popular Songbook are the brilliant lyricists, what they can do with that simple theme of I Love You. So let's go from Cole Porter to Sammy Kahn. I think it's just really one of the most evocative and insightful lyricists on the subject of love. I'm in 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 love, 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 I'm in love. I'm in love.
He's in love.
I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love. I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love, I'm in love. Love is a bore. Love is a ball game without a score. Love is a sailboat without a sail, the lock on the candy store. Asparagus without the hollandaise, plus all the belly laughs in Tennessee Williams plays. I used to love it, but now it's a drag. Love is a flagpole without a flag. Love is the mailman without the mail. A comic without a gag. A soap opera plot plus lots and lots more. But mainly, I mean, love's a bore. It's I'll call you tomorrow. It's a phone that never rings. It's a sack full of sorrow or a ride on angel's wings. So just remember the next time you soar, love is an exit without a door. But if you're in love, you'll ignore all the things that I've said heretofore. It's that ride in a hansom when the world was light and gay. It's the heart you can't ransom that you lightly gave away. So just remember the next time you soar, love is an exit without a door. But if you're in love, you'll ignore all the things that I've said heretofore. Whatever he does will come back and be the bore that he was. Once a bore. Sammy Kahn. He put a very interesting spin on the theme of love and marriage. All right. Behold the way our fine feathered friend his virtue doth parade. Thou knowest not, my dim-witted friend, the picture thou hast made. Thy vacant brow and thy tousled hair conceal thy good intent, thou noble, upright, truthful, sincere, and slightly dopey gent. You're my funny Valentine. Sweet, comic, You're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than Greek? Is your mouth a little weak? When you open it to speak, are you smart? But don't change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine. Stay. Change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay, little Valentine, stay. Each day is Valentine. National anthem of Valentine's Day, and I want to thank KT for suggesting that I sing it today. I do have one other Valentine's baby up my sleeve, and it's maybe the most significant Valentine's baby in my life, and that would be my mom. She and my dad fell in love in 1950. In 1952, they eloped to Las Vegas, and this Tony Bennett song was their song, so I want to say I'm here tonight because of Tony Bennett. I'm here tonight because of my parents and my Valentine's mama. And most of all, I'm here because of all of you. So thank you. There's a song in my heart. Because of you, my romance had its start. Because of you, the sun will shine. The moon and stars will say, you're mine forever and never to part. I only live for your love and your kiss. And smile because of you. because of you. There's a song in my heart. Thank you, Alex Rybeck.
Jeff Harner, don't change a hair for me. Not if you care for me. Stay. Little Valentine, I'd love you to stay, but I'm introducing our third Valentine for the evening. Love and be mine. Be mine. Now, our third Valentine is also a winner of the Donald Smith Award, and she's won many awards, and she is a regular. I'm talking every month at Birdland. She put on a new show, and this has been for a few years, actually. She puts on a new show every month. Of course, that came to a halt about a year ago, but every month, a different tribute to a different star. It was so exciting, and she's such an anchor there that her picture is on the wall at Birdland. She's a legend all over the world. But what I love most about her is her heart. Last week we were teaching at the Performing Arts High School, virtually, of course, and these kids who've lost a year of their prime high school year, Natalie is a wonderful master teacher, and she's the master teacher for the Mabel Mercer Foundation. She was teaching these children as they're in their bedrooms with their bunk bed behind them with the little stuffed toys, or one of them was actually in their closet singing to the camera, their little cell phone or whatever it was, and such a yearning, such a desire to communicate, and we felt the joy through the screen. I thought it might be impossible, but it is possible, just like we're having this night here, this virtual night here. But Nellie's also taught with us in Durango, Colorado. She teaches with us at the Cayman Arts Festival, thanks to our friends Crystal and Bob Lovard. She teaches all over the world, and here in New York, of course, with our Larry and Adele Al Teen Scholarship, which will happen again soon, virtually. We're so happy that will be here this year too, virtually. But as she travels around the world, I must say one of my favorite quotes is from Clive Davis in London, where she got 5 stars. He called her, he said that she was in a class of her own and called her a force of nature. So I think it's something every Valentine show needs, is a force of nature. Ladies and gentlemen, Natalie Douglas.
I love you, Katie. You're a hoot. Hey kids, how are you? Okay. Oh, listen, sister, I love my Mr. Man, and I can tell you why. There ain't no reason why I should love that man. It must be something that the angels done play. Fish gotta swim and birds gotta fly. I gotta love one man till I die. Can't help loving that man of mine. Tell me he's lazy. Tell me he's slow. Tell me I'm crazy. Maybe I know. Can't help loving that man of mine. When he goes away, that's a rainy day. But when he comes back, that day is fine. The sun will shine. He can come home late as can be. Home without him ain't no home to me. Can't help loving that man of mine. When he goes away, that's a rainy day. But when he comes back, that day is fine. The sun will shine. He can come home late as can be.
Kids, and I hope you're snuggled up with the one you love. And if you're not with the one you love, well, now you are. Hi, I love you. We all love you. And we're happy to spend this evening with you and sing songs of love and heart and all of its many permutations. Now, this next song is a favorite of Crystal Lovers. Hi, Crystal. It's a favorite of mine, too. It's a Shirley Bassey tune. And it's one of those love songs from the 60s, 70s that's kind of like, you know, this relationship would be really awesome if you were completely different. It's that, you know? And it seems like it's a really happy thing. And then you listen to the lyrics really carefully and you realize that maybe it's kind of devastating. Enjoy. I'd like to run away from you, but if you never found me, I would die. I'd like to break the chains you put around me, but I know I never will. You stay away, and all I do is wonder why the hell I wait for you. But when did common sense prevail for lovers when we know it never will? So what's the good of loving as I do? And though you always laugh at love, nothing else could be good enough for you. Impossible to live with you, but I know I could never live without you. For whatever you make me laugh, you make me cry, you make me live, you make me die for you. You make me sing, you make me sad, you make me glad, you make me mad for you. With someone, and I've been lucky enough to be madly in love with my husband for, I guess this summer we'll celebrate the 29th anniversary of our first date. That's insane. I don't even know how that happened. But it's true. And most days I wake up and I look at him and I think, oh, you are the love of my life, and I'm so glad I found you. And some days I wake up and I look at him and I think, oh, you're still here. Yeah. And, you know, there are songs about that, too. I was so happy when I found this one. This next one talks about that. It was actually written as a tribute to June Carter Cash and Johnny Cash, which is really kind of cool. Because, you know, their relationship was tumultuous, shall we say. And but when I heard it, I thought, you know what? This applies to every couple I've ever known. And, you know, it probably applies to you, too, wherever you are out there.
I don't feel like loving you today, so don't you dare to try and change my mind. The best thing you can do right now is just go away, 'cause I don't feel like loving you today. I don't want to talk about last night. I'm angry and I didn't get much sleep. And I'm so tired and bloodshot, there's no telling what I'd say. But I don't feel like loving you today, but you know I will anyway. Even though we make it hard sometimes, I'll wind up forgiving you and probably loving you for the rest of my life. But I don't feel like loving you today, and I've got 16 hours left to go. I might tell you that I'm leaving, even though you know I'll stay. Still, I don't feel like loving you today, but you know I will anyway. Even though we make it hard sometimes, for the rest of my life. But I don't feel like loving you today. I just don't feel like loving you today.
Thank you, John. Oh, God. You know what I mean? I know you do. But, you know, really, truly, this last song that I have for you guys is how I really feel. It's not exactly true. I didn't fall in love with my husband the very first time I saw him. I thought he was cute, and he was a good actor. I met him when he was in a show that my best friend's lover was in. But I didn't fall, you know. Then he left the show, he grew a beard, and he grew his hair really long, and he looked like Jesus, and Jesus is hot. And then I fell in love the first time I saw him with the beard and the, oh, yeah. And it's been like that for 29 years. And this is how I feel when I see him every morning.
First time ever I saw your face, I thought the sun rose in your eyes, and the moon and the stars gifts you gave to the dark and the endless sky. The first time ever I
kissed your mouth. A felt the earth move in my hands, like the trembling heart of a captive that was there, and my command that was there, and my
Douglas, what would we do without you? In fact, what would we do with all these great composers? I love composers. I love their music. I love their lyrics. You've heard from Sammy Kahn tonight and Larry Hart and also Oscar Hammerstein with Richard Rodgers. You've heard from Jerome Kern. It's a plethora of wonderful composers, but I'm very happy that I knew someone named Carol Hall. She wrote words and music. And she wrote this song in 1970. And she wrote it for her husband, Leonard Maslin, after they met. It was love. And I'd like to dedicate it to my funny Valentine, Steve Downey. My love has a special way of waking me. He looks upon my face until I open up my eyes. Yes, he wakes me with his mind, and then he smiles. smiles at my surprise and he says, ain't love easy? If it's you, babe, ain't love easy? If it's you, babe, lots of friendly things to do, babe. Ain't love easy? My love knows the sweetest way to pleasure me. Before I close my eyes, I'll tell him, ain't love easy? If it's you, babe, living was easy 'cause of you, babe. And maybe dying's easy too, babe. Lots of friendly, sweet talk, lifetime things to do, babe. Ain't love easy? Thank you, John Weber and Carol Hall. Now, it was almost a year ago we started sheltering in place. Now, this is very different from you because I was used to going out almost every night. I thought of this Fats Waller tune. No one to talk with, all by myself. No one to walk with, but I'm happy on the shelf. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. Or don't go out late, don't care to go. I'm home about eight, just me and my radio. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. Like Jack Horner in the corner. Don't go nowhere, what do I care? Your kisses always waiting for me. Don't care to go. I'm home about it, just me and my radio. Ain't misbehaving, I'm saving my love for you. Take it, John Weber. But keep the whole horse before the cart. First, you gotta have heart. John Weber is a genius, as you probably know. We also have a genius over here behind the lens. The man who made all this virtual, made the virtual cabaret convention possible because his mastery of all things virtual. Mr. Chinua Thomas, thank you very much for choosing to make this evening possible. The whole virtual cabaret, we did it. A first virtual cabaret convention, we did it. Thank you. Thank you for everyone for making this possible. I want to thank Donald Smith. I want to thank Mabel Mercer. I want to thank Rick Meadows, Jason Martin, Alice Fennell. I want to thank our scribe, John Fricke, who gave me the idea of the title, Miles and Miles and Miles of Art. Thank you so much. First, most of all, I want to thank our board, Mabel Mercer Foundation. Thank you so much. And most especially, our board chairman, Charles Bullock, who gave us this Valentine of a baby grand right here. He and his wife Sue gave this to us in all these concerts from the Mabel Mercer Foundation. Yes, this is the Mabel Mercer Foundation office at 930 6th Avenue, the Film Center. Stop off and see us sometime. We are open, well, masked and open. Yes, thank you for tonight. And you know, I was thinking, I want to thank all of you for keeping my friend Danny Apollinar. He wrote a song with Addie Feger called While We're Here. And it goes like this. While we're here, keep the music playing. Let the sound drown out our fear. And Noel Coward said, together with music. It's the music that keeps us together. So I'd like to end with the last song that George Gershwin wrote, last melody he wrote in 1937. The words are by Ira Gershwin. And it's perfect for this crazy time we're in right now, but we're together with music. The more I read the papers, the less I comprehend the world and all its capers and how it all will end. Nothing seems to be lasting, but that isn't our affair. We have something permanent, I mean, in the way we care. It's very clear. Our love is here to stay. Not for a year, but ever. Thank you.